I'm Michelle Leafloor, the Vice President of Health Information Technology Services and the CIO at Hamilton Health Sciences. Cyber, the other daily conversation. It'd be great if healthcare was a never event in the cyber world, but to be honest, that's not a reality. We even spoke to my board recently about this. They're like, what are you doing about cyber? I said, well, it's not a never event. So what we're doing is, you know, on the technology side, working with all of our vendors, not necessarily just our, what you would think of cyber related vendors, but all of our vendors to understand what they're doing to improve their own security posture and how collectively those tools will improve our security posture. I think we just talked about AI. I think you're seeing in all of our tooling in the cyber world that AI has a great opportunity to continue to evolve the nice robust tools that we have to really be looking at unusual patterns in a different way that might not currently be available. So we need to continue to be open to that. And I think that is, like you said, AI for network monitoring, but also the expanded role for AI in our cybersecurity office and the tooling that we used. Technology on the clinical front doesn't stay static, and it doesn't on the cyber front either. So we need to continue to evolve those and continue to work with all of our partners. Cyber for me, though, outside of technology, which is key, I think, as I said, it's not a never event. So really, how are organizations spending enough time or putting enough effort into incident response plans? Not necessarily just in my security team, who are fabulous and run tabletop exercises frequently, but how do we run these processes with our clinical stakeholders? We've learned with a number of unfortunate events recently around the province of Ontario and worldwide that the security folks generally have a great incident response plan. They can execute it, but the pieces that need focus in those planning is when you lose your cancer treatment center, what are you doing? Have you thought through all of those pieces? So we're trying to expand our incident response thinking to be more than just technology focused, but how do we wrap it into an overall organizational plan? And as we unfortunately learn from our partners and our peers around the globe, we take those exercises in-house and work with our clinical stakeholders and groups to continue to evolve that, to be as ready as you can be. And I put that way specifically because the folks on the other side of the cyber world continue to evolve. So we need to continue to evolve, but, most certainly it's a not a never event world. I guess I would put it that way. Most cyber events, most that come into healthcare and other organizations, it's, you know, taking advantage of human error. You know, phishing is a real thing and they're good. So what do you do around continuous education of your teams in your organization? It's not a foolproof thing to think that education is going to solve all of those, but you know, you need to continue to move that needle. So the people understand what phishing is, what best practices are. We run our own campaigns, and as people might fail, I fall for a phishing item. We have a little reminded education that goes out. So it's not about punishment, but it's about improvement. So that said, though, education is only going to go so far, but it is one of the components. So we've got technology, we've got planning, and we've got education, and we need to keep moving all three of those arenas forward and hopefully get some sleepful nights while worrying about cybersecurity. So a lot of collaboration going on. Historically, you know, if you had a cyber event, it was very insular, and components of it still are insular. You have to do your assessment in that, but we would never find out what happens to hospital X or organization Y. In Ontario, Ontario Health has recognized the need to collaborate, I think driven by organizations that we were all striving to understand information and how we can shore up our own environments as we learn these things. So our province has realized the need to collaborate more, and across the sector has defined what's called a local service delivery group. So in different regions, organizations like ours who have a fairly high security posture and evolving are called upon to work with area organizations, starting with hospitals, but this will branch out beyond hospitals, to really create like standards for incident response, incident tooling, but also to look at the tooling that they have and how we can transform across our industry using common tool sets around cyber. So I think that collaboration has really progressed. Again, it comes on the, you learn how it's progressing on the unfortunate events of that are occurring in the industry. And the more recent cyber events in our province, we've seen far more rapid sharing of information and indicators than we historically would have, which I think bodes well for where we're going in the sector, to learn from each other, but to help each other while we're in the midst of a crisis. So collaboration, I don't think collaboration can ever go wrong in anything that we're talking about, AI, cyber, teamwork. This area in cyber, I think, is going to be key across our industry, and collaboration outside of healthcare too. We don't, every sector has different learnings. And so my CISO is in tune to a number of different groups that are federal or international to understand things outside of healthcare as well. So I love to see that evolving cyber collaboration.